What's up everyone? Welcome to my channel. This is Julia Trevita here, your teacher vlogger and educator here on YouTube. And I am bringing you another video. If you're new here, please do consider subscribing to my YouTube channel and don't forget to hit the notification bell to get notified whenever I upload new videos just like this. You may also shoot me a message on my Facebook and Instagram account, so just search Cup of Juliet. Let me know what you wanna hear more of. For today's episode, we are going to talk about the freeze hiring announced by Novakid. Today, I am also going to answer some of your questions. Now, if you're interested to learn more about it, please keep on watching. Now, if you're ready, let's get started in 3, 2, 1. Hi again, fellow teachers and Novakid applicants. Yes, I have sad news for you. Now, on November 1, 2021, Novakid announced that they will stop hiring teachers in the meantime. Now, allow me to read their statement. Now, here on their Instagram account, Novakid said, "We are cold and sad to inform you that Novakid stops accepting new applicants and announces a hiring freeze for all categories of teachers until further notice." So this means that both for native speakers and non-native speakers. Okay, now Novakid added, "We have been happy to hire all of you guys, but the situation in the market in such an easy times is quite unpredictable. We really hope that this is temporary and we will resume the hiring process soon. Let's stay in touch. We will definitely inform you once the hiring freeze is over. Yours truly, Novakid team." There you have it, teachers. Kaya naman for those who are planning to apply in Novakid, I am sorry to say, but you have to postpone your application for now. But teachers, don't take it as a setback, but rather a setup. Take it as an opportunity to prepare yourself, and maybe once Novakid lifted the freeze hiring, you will be more ready to undergo the application process, and who knows, you will eventually get hired in Novakid. Just think positive and don't lose hope. Now let's answer the question, why did Novakid implement freeze hiring? Now here, Novakid said that freeze hiring occurs when the demand for slots in the ESL industry is less than the actual number of open slots. Now in such situations, now the company's focus shifts towards enrolling new students to provide a fair workload for its teachers, both for current and future teachers. Now once the goal is achieved, the company resumes the hiring process. As we all know, a lot of ESL teachers who are teaching Chinese students have been affected by the new policy implemented by the Chinese government. That is why a lot of ESL teachers have applied in Novakid, since Novakid has European and Russian students, and plus they offer higher compensation for their teachers. This is also Novakid's way to avoid overhiring and prevent situations like zero and low bookings, which is why this move is beneficial for us current teachers and of course future teachers. Now just imagine if you are a new teacher and you experience low booking or zero booking, you might feel discouraged or demotivated, right? And Novakid doesn't want that to happen, which is why there is freeze hiring to ensure that the number of teachers is enough for the number of their students. In my observation din kasi, wala masyado nagre-resign sa NovaKid. Kaya they have enough number of teachers and they don't need to constantly hire more teachers. Kaya for now, they are looking for more students to be able to hire more teachers. They really ensure na enough yung ratio ng teachers and students. They really live up to their promise of equal workload for all their teachers. Now, what will happen if you are already in the middle of the application process? Don't worry, teachers, because this freeze hiring is only applicable for new applicants. Let's say, for example, you have already submitted all your requirements, underwent the technical test, and scheduled your demo, then you can still push that through. However, this freeze hiring might slow down your profile activation. Based on my experience, NovaKid announced freeze hiring last June in the middle of my application process. Although my application was not affected at all, however, matagal ako na launch teachers, it really is a big factor kung bakit matagal yung profile activation ko. I actually submitted all my requirements on June 7 and NovaKid announced freeze hiring on June 12. Thank God, umabot teachers. Kaya huwag na kayo mag-hesitate, for example, if you are really interested to apply in NovaKid, because we'll never know kung kailan talaga sila mag-freeze hiring. Last time, their announcement says, now, as you know, in the teaching business, summer is a low season. We at NovaKid try our best to attract new students and retain the current ones. Decent workload is our main priority. Therefore, we are announcing a hiring freeze for near-native teachers. Please do not refer anyone to HR department until further notice. Actually, at that time, I was worried kasi I was scheduled for demo na. But Teacher Winnie Benedicto, my ambassador, assured us that our application is not affected. However, she told us that it might delay our profile activation. And it took us nga 2 months because of the freeze hiring. Let me share to you, teachers, the timeline of my application. Now here on June 28, I got the job offer and I was officially activated on September 6 and had my first day on September 7. Now, so from the time that I submitted my requirements on June 7, until I got activated on September 7, since abutan nga ako ng freeze hiring. So it took me 3 months, but it's all worth it naman. Now, when are they going to resume the application? Now, so what NovaKid said in their statement, they will resume the hiring soon. Maybe once there is enough number of students, and I believe they will announce that one on their official social media account. So just keep yourself posted. But before kasi, just to give you one idea, diba NovaKid announced freeze hiring on June 12. Then the following month, I think mga third week of July, they began accepting new applicants. So maybe just, you know, after a month, we'll never know. And my advice, if you are interested to apply NovaKid, once the application resumes, submit your application right away kasi madami teachers who are interested to work with NovaKid too. Kaya huwag niyo ako tularan, teachers, kasi at first nag-hesitate din ako na mag-apply kasi I was not confident at the time and I also got scared na baka I might fail in the application process. Kaya tuloy, it took me 2 months pa. Okay, kaya always check the social media accounts of NovaKid for further announcement and grab the opportunity once it opens, once the application process opens. And that's all for today, teachers. I hope that you learned something from this video. Now, if you have recommendations, content suggestions, and questions, just let me know in the comment section below. Now, if you want ESL-related contents, don't forget to subscribe in my YouTube channel. Now, before I end this video, let me give a shout out to our commenter of the week. So, our commenter of the week is Teacher Rachel Barreda. So, she said, I've been watching demos, but I found their videos too overwhelming. Thank God found your videos. Everything is on point. Thank you so much. Oh, thank you so much, teachers, for supporting my channel. And good luck with your application. Thank you so much for watching. This is Julia Ervida. See you again next time. Goodbye.